Thank you. Thank you all for being here tonight. It really means the world to me. Before I go on, Dr. Zone, are you out there? There he is. I need to give a huge thanks to Dr. Zone. For the past 4.5 years, he's put up with me. You've been my mentor and my teacher. And it's been a tough road, but if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be on this stage today. Thank you, Dr. Zone. This last set of pieces I'm playing for you is by a composer I know named Joseph Williams. He wrote each piece in the set based on a piece of folklore and myth from New Mexico. And I don't think I would be doing these pieces justice if I did not read you the folklore. So starting with La Loba, this one's in the form of a poem. La Loba is a wild woman, a witch who scours the desert collecting the bones of wolves. She collects them all, from paw to fang, and once she has every piece, she builds a fire. She lays them out in the shape of a skeleton and stops to ponder what song she will sing. When she has found the right song, she lifts her arms, begins to dance, and her song pours into the air. Slowly, muscle and tendon cover the bones. La Loba sings. Fur covers flesh. She sings more, and a new wolf begins to breathe. Thank you. The Seven Cities of Gold, and by extension Hawiku, is the first Spanish myth of New Mexico. After the conquistador Hernan Cortes found the Aztecs' gold-laden city of Tenochtitlan in 1519, the Spanish fostered hopes that there were other cities filled with the riches of the New World. In 1539, Spain sent an expedition to the unoccupied northern lands led by Friar Marcos de Niza, in response to rumors of Cibola and the Seven Cities of Gold. After a long and brutal trip, the party arrived in western New Mexico, where Cibola was said to exist. The friar sent scouts to investigate, but these groups were rebuffed with heavy casualties by the native tribes. Due to the threats of mutiny and fear for his own safety, the friar elected to examine a pueblo from the distance. As the friar looked across the desert landscape, the intense sun and heat helped to create an illusion he was desperate to see. A modest pueblo was emblazoned by the sun and his imagination to appear as a small but brilliant city of gold. Satisfied, the expedition returned to Mexico City. When an enthusiastic Spanish entourage, led by the friar, later returned, they suffered the same arduous journey, only to find the small pueblo of Hawiku with dirt roads, white plaster buildings, and turquoise as its most valuable possessions.
Thank you.
Zozobra is the name of a massive effigy that is burned each year as part of the fall fiestas in Santa Fe, New Mexico. In 2015, he was 70 feet tall, with bone-white skin and great black eyes. One hand has fingers crossed in the symbol of lies, and the other, the sign of the devil. In advance of the fiestas, the community writes down the fears and worries of the previous year on tiny slips of paper. These slips are placed in the belly of Zozobra. On the day of Zozobra, a great crowd gathers before the effigy, and the ritual begins with fire dancers. The mayor of Santa Fe speaks on behalf of the community and charges Zozobra with his crimes. No longer will we live under your tyranny of fear. Zozobra is sentenced to death. The crowd yells, "Burn him!" as the great effigy is lit on fire. Zozobra moans and flails, and the crowd delights in his death.